Good morning, Rabotai. We're starting a new week, Be'ezrat Hashem. It'll be a fresh week, a nice, beautiful week for Be'ezrat Hashem. Now, Morav Rabotai, this parasha, in Eretz Israel, they read the next parasha. Here we're going to read Parashat Be'alotcha. We see something extraordinary about this parasha, that Aaron, he got sad when he saw that the Nesi'im, every one of them, had a special day, but Aaron, he didn't have any special day. And Aaron was very sad. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu came to Aaron and he said to him, your merit is even bigger than them. Because the Nesi'im, their sacrifice that they do, it's one time. But you are going to light the menorah every day. And not only that, every day, le'olam, le'olmei olamim, ever, forever, the menorah will be lit. And it is going to be on your merit, on your zechut. Now, Morav Rabotai, let me ask you a question. Okay. Aaron is sad because he cannot be part of the Nesi'im to do the sacrifice of the Nesi'im. Hashem Yitbarach, he tells him, don't worry, Shelcha gdola mishelahem, yours is bigger than them. But Aaron was Kohen Gadol. Why you have to be sad? For what? You cannot take everything. It's like you have a cake. You cannot eat the entire cake. Leave a portion for the others. Take one cake and leave the others. So why is Aaron Kohen is sad? But this is exactly when you talk about a cake and live for others, when you talk about a meal, live for others, don't be stingy, don't eat everything. But in mitzvot, it's not the same. In mitzvot, what the Torah wants to show you, every mitzvah that you see that can come in your hand, don't let it go. It's not like leave the cake for everyone. The mitzvah that comes to your hand, if you can do it, run for it. And if you don't do it, feel sorry for it that you didn't do the mitzvah. And this is what Aaron HaKohen wanted to teach us, a big lesson. Mitzvah ba'a b'yadecha al tachmitzena. If there is a mitzvah that comes to your end, don't let it go. Because you don't know when you're going to do this mitzvah again, and you don't know if you will have any chance to do this mitzvah. So Aaron HaKohen, he had very big sadness. But look, what is the Torah tells us? Be'alotcha et hanerot el mul penei ha-menorah. So Aaron HaKohen, he was lighting the be'alotcha et hanerot. What do you mean be'alotcha et hanerot? That you lift the candles. The Torah to tell me, be'adlikcha et hanerot, when you light the candles. Why, when you bring up the candles, you don't bring up the candles, you light the candles. Elama, the Torah wants to tell you something very big. That Aaron HaKohen, he had such a koach to do all the kavanot, and when he was lighting the menorah, like the Torah says, Ken asa et ha-menorah, that he did exactly like Hashem Yitbarach wanted it. With the all kavanot, he took the menorah up to the shamayim. He took it to the highest place of spirituality. And that's what the Torah says, be'alotcha. Not only that you light the candle and the candle you sit on the table. Aaron HaKohen, he was lighting the menorah and he was able to take care of very up in the shamayim. Now, the Torah says that the menorah is forever, right? Hashem said to Aaron, why you are sorry? The menorah is forever. Today there is no menorah. So what is forever? Torah. When you learn Torah, the Torah that we do, it is the fire of the menorah. When we have the zechut to come and to listen to a shiur Torah, when we come to the Bet HaKnesset, we pray, Shacharit, Mincha, Aravit, this בעלותך את המנורה. We're taking the menorah, the fire of the Torah, הקדושה, and we can lift it. So בעזרת השם יתברך, יש ברוך הוא, will give all of us נחת, שלמה, פרנסה, ישועות גדולות, רפואה שלמה, רצון, ונאמר אמן.